Hey guys, it's time to run some trains. I gotta finish up what I was doing the other day. Down to the last three cars on that first cut. Cars going to Summers. It's a gondola. Last two aggregate cars here going to Jefferson. That takes care of the first cut. So we'll run these locals down the number one track. Get down there and get that other cut. Cars. Got a couple on to where that IC plug door boxcar is, that orange boxcar. That's our next string. See if we got it. We got it. Let's stretch them. four of those UP covered offers are going to Chicago. So temporarily I am putting them on the Des Moines track, since nothing's going to be going to Des Moines out of this string, because this is where this train came from. So I'm using the Des Moines track to hold all my Chicago cars, because the Chicago cars go all the way other to the other end of the yard, to the east end. So I'll just put them all here and then push them down there later. I didn't think I got it, so let's try again. I got it that time. So all four of these UP cars will be put on this track here. Overran my magnet. Try it again. I guess it doesn't want to work. One more time. Doesn't work this time, I do it manual. Manuel. There we go. This should work this time. Sorry, I was playing with my cards, lost track. There we go. Alright, this hopper is going to stay here in Marshalltown. It is bound for the green track in Marshalltown. Ain't this so exciting? Let's see if there's any more in this deck that's going to Marshalltown. Yes, I the very last one of these. Okay. Two more cars for the Chicago string. Good couple again, so I believe it was on the magnet. North Central Boxcar is going to be staying here, so I'll put it with the rest of the Marshalltown string over here. Bam! Got it. Okay. Push them all the way down here. These first three will be put on the green Marshalltown track, and then the IC car will be going to the yellow track. We'll put the caboose away last. Crew likes the caboose. It's got the coffee in it. So my new GP9 is running really good so far. I like it. My opinion is this. Walters, the Lifelike and the regular Proto, or their mainline, I guess I should say, all them engines run really good. Athern, it seems to be hit and miss. Sometimes I get some that run pretty good, and other times I get some that I'm not so happy with. I have to do a lot of work on them. And even with the work on them, sometimes I still don't get them to run the way I want them to. They're not real smooth. But most of these Walters engines have been really good. Something about that helical gear thing they have, I guess. Alright, so what I'm doing here is I am going to back up to the Council Bluffs string, which is, I got to throw this switch, which is that bulkhead flat right behind that seaboard coastline, or that family lines hopper. And I gotta pull that whole string out. And pull it completely out, the whole Council Bluff string. And then I will couple on to that family lines hopper car and pull it out. I don't know if this is going to make any sense to you. Well, just watch and you'll see. Okay. The reason being is the Chicago cars go to the east end of this same track that I'm pulling out of right now. This track is Council Bluffs on this end, westbound cars going out of the yard. And the other end is eastbound, going to Chicago. So they occupy the same track, just different ends of it. There, I explained that better than I thought I could. So this is the whole cut of Council Bluffs card I'm pulling out now. westbounders leaving it. They'll be picked up by a westbound train coming from staging. And we pretend we take it to Council Bluffs and all points west. I do a lot of pretending. I pretend I'm a model railroader. Okay, so as soon as it clears the switch, we'll back up and get this Chicago string. Eastbound cars. Got a good couple. All right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 10 cars that will go to the east end of the yard. It's a pretty good load for these two Jeeps. It's I think a total of 26 cars in this string, plus the caboose, so 27. I've got her notched up. Might be spinning a little bit. That's why you generally have to use two locos to switch the yard, just because of the trimming the tracks. You usually get quite a few cars in a string sometimes. Alright, let me throw this switch and we'll shove them down to the east end, hopefully. Stop them on that magnet and cut them where I need to, just put it in delay, and I can shove it all the way to the other end and I don't have to walk down there and uncouple them. I get a little lazy when I sit in my chair. So we need to cut it between that family lines covered and that ADM hopper car. Right, there's the magnet. Right there. And I'll probably have to finagle the couplers a little bit. Doesn't always work real well on these curves. Alright, it's uncoupled, but it's not going to go into delay. I help it. Alright. Alright, now it's in delay, so I'm going to push it all the way down. So we're pushing this 10 cars on the end of this string all the way down to the east end of the yard. Two Jeeps handled it pretty well. Now, how far do I push it, do you ask? I have an easy way to know without even getting up. Let's see if I can zoom in down there. See that cross buck right there? That's about where I need to stop them, so they're not fouling the other end down there. It all worked out perfectly to put that cross buck there by that track. But right about there is good. Ain't that ingenious? So remember, they're in delay. So all I gotta do is pull the string back and my east end cut is tied down right there. So we'll bring this cut. This is the Council Bluffs, the rest of these cars. Okay, the rest of this is all the Council Bluffs string, so we'll cut it loose from the caboose here as soon as I get to this magnet. See if it works. No, let's see. Well, how about that? Okay. So now all I got, the crew's got to do is put away this caboose. Take it down to the caboose track. So I think that's enough. This was a lot of fun. I don't get to run my trains enough. I think my wife is calling for dinner anyway. Y'all have a good one.